Hello, everybody. My name is Steven, and I'm here to talk to you today about how you could boost your database performance with Amazon ElastiCache. My agenda for today is the value of adding a caching service, how actually it is better together pairing your database workload with the caching service. I'm going to make a claim there. Then I'm going to go through a couple of cost-saving scenarios, how you could reduce your cost and boost your performance. I will back that up with the demo, where I will run a demo of the same workload with and without the caching service. I will end today's session by answering your questions. So let's look at the challenges that our customers face. One of the biggest challenges that our customer face is latency. An unresponsive, slow application could end up costing you financially by one of two ways, either turning away customers or your operation starts to suffer. This is often the result of databases being slow or struggling to meet modern application performance requirements. So what happens? Applications have figured out how to scale very quickly by adding such things as microservices or container-based solutions, but databases don't have too many options when it comes to scaling. Pretty much the only options are either to scale up, bring in a bigger database instance, or scale out, adding multiple read replicas to the database. Both of these solutions end up costing more, either in licensing cost or hardware instance cost. So the question is, how can we strike a better balance between the demand for performance and the cost? And my suggestion is that the better balance can be struck by introducing a caching service. A caching service will help you either reduce the database size or stop a database from growing, or adding multiple read replicas, therefore lowering your license cost, lowering your database cost altogether. At the same time, the caching service will help modernize your applications. You will basically separate the reads from the writes. The reads are going to go to your caching service, and the writes will still go to the database for permanent storage. Therefore, a caching service will reduce your overall database cost and overall cost while increasing your application performance. How can we do this? Well, for this, we have Amazon ElastiCache. Amazon ElastiCache is a high-performance in-memory caching service that is super fast and scalable with auto-recovery, and it can even scale across to multiple regions. It has a 4 nines SLA. It can self-detect errors and self-recover, and at the same time secure. Both encryption address and in transit is available and meets multiple compliance and certification requirements. The service is a fully managed service, as you expected from many Amazon services, and at the same time is open source compatible. So if you already use Memcached or Redis on your code, you don't even have to rewrite it. The managed service takes care of everything for you, installation, even backup, and instance recovery is taken care of for you, patching as well. So what are the financial benefits? Are they real? Yes, the claim is that it's real. Especially on an RDS service using the MySQL engine, you could achieve up to 55% reduction in cost and up to 80x faster read response performance. Now, this is applicable to read-heavy workloads. A caching service only makes sense when you have a read workload, and especially when you have more reads than writes. At the same time, what's happening, the caching will help you reduce the database traffic because all the read traffic is going to come out from a caching service that it's super fast. It's memory-based. Nothing is faster than reading data from memory. At the same time, the fees for ElastiCache are very simple. You only pay a per-instance fee without a separate I/O charge. As a result, the combination of these two, you will decrease your database cost, overall database cost, by licensing fee or instancing fee, and boost your application performance. Now let's look at a couple of cost savings and performance boosting scenarios. Scenario one, there are two types of cost saving scenarios when you pair your database with ElastiCache. The first one is this one that we're going to look at, is when a database is not meeting application demands and is going to be scaled up. It's no strange to many of us that applications can scale very easily due to such things as container-based solutions or microservices when the application can scale very easily. So when that happens, that puts more load on the database. And traditionally what that meant that the database administrator had to scale up the database. So basically you find yourself where the green arrow points and life was good, but when the application scaled up, you had to scale up the database, and then you move down to the red arrow. This obviously provided you a database instance with more CPU, more memory, and a bit of a faster network. However, it also doubled your cost. An alternate to this, instead of scaling up the database instance every time the application demands more performance, is to add a caching service to it, where the gray arrow is pointing. This has obvious benefits to it because it also doubles your CPU count, increases your memory by more than double, and it also doubles your network throughput. At this point, you separated your reads from the writes, so your application functions as it did before, as far as writes are concerned, is writing to the same database, but the reads are going to come out of the cache. This provides an enormous boost to your performance and reduces your cost for a flat fee of $300. Now, obviously, this can be compared to the 6 times the cost that it would cost to increase the database instance. The second scenario, which also looks a little bit more as an architecture diagram, is when the database instance has already been scaled to meet the maximum application demand. Now, we all know that the applications do not perform at maximum demand at all times. Most of the time, they just, you know, at the base level. But sometimes they demand higher throughputs. And databases are often sized to meet that maximum demand because they can't easily be sized. So in this case, we have a Postgres database that was scaled to a 4XL instance, plus a read replica was added to it for high availability. Now, under this configuration for this workload, this would cost the client about $63,000 a year. An alternate to this is to add a caching service and scale back the database. So actually using a 4XL as it was in the past, now it can use a 2XL instance, which will instantly realize significant cost savings. Now that is paired up with the caching service, the database instance, not the database such in size, could be cut in half. One might think that, yes, okay, this is going to add some cost savings to my workload, but will it perform at the same level? Yes, it will. We have run numerous tests and numerous benchmarkings where we were able to simulate that the performance is not going to suffer by adding a caching service and reducing the database size. In fact, our test has proven that we could actually increase the transactions per second. For this very same configuration, we were able to increase the transactions per second by about 30%, from 10,000 to 13,000 transactions per second. And the average response time was reduced from 19 milliseconds to 9. So we not only realized over 50% savings, but we boosted the performance by 30% and reduced response time by 50%. So now we're going to run a demo to see how this works. I'm going to kick off the demo first. And while the demo is running, I'm going to go through, see what the demo does so that we could save some time. In this first scenario, I'm going to run a workload that is already planned that is going to use the database only. So this is called scenario one. We're going to run 25 threads, and each thread is going to execute 10,000 transactions. So let this one run. In the second window, we will execute the same workload. However, this is called scenario two. Let's just clear the screen, makes it easier. So in this case, we call scenario two. In scenario two, the same workload, 25 threads executing 10,000 transactions. However, this time is going to use a caching service. So while this is running, I'm going to jump back to the presentation to see what is actually happening here. In the demo that is running in the background, we basically have simulated a number of clients that are running on EC2 instances, and they're connecting to Aurora Postgres database. Nothing new there. That's scenario one. What we did in scenario two, we introduced a caching service. In this case, it's Amazon ElastiCache for Redis. So what this caching service does, it's implementing something called the lazy loading algorithm. That's what the code is running there. That's scenario two. So what it does, it's actually going to connect to the ElastiCache first, and it's going to look for this very specific SQL query output. If that output is in the cache service, it's going to pull it out of the cache, and no database access is needed. So obviously, the database is not going to resolve that. However, if that's called a cache hit, by the way, if the caching service doesn't have that very specific SQL output, then we go to the database and execute the command as we did in the past. That's called a cache miss because the result was not in the cache, and we pull it out of the database. However, we add a trick to it. This is step three. What we do at this point, we save the output in the caching service so that the subsequent execution is going to find it in the cache. So perhaps one time the database is going to be hit when the result is not there, but any subsequent ones will not. Let's see if you could jump back and see if our tests have completed and see how they performed. All right. Both tests have completed. So this is scenario one, where we do not use a caching service, and we have some numbers here and statistics. So if you look at it, for example, the minimum time was about 3.1 milliseconds, the first set. And then later on, the database got a little bit better. It went down to about 2.9 milliseconds, which is not bad. That was the minimum time. The maximum time was significantly higher. These were the write statements. By the way, this actually executes 80% reads and 20% writes. Now, if we look in the second set where we actually use the caching service, we can see that the minimum time dropped down to 0.7 and 0.5 milliseconds. These are significantly faster than 2 or even more than 3 milliseconds. We're talking about 4 or 5x increase here in performance. We actually have the capability to analyze these logs. And I captured those through tool here that could do that for me, analyze each one of them. Now, for ease of understanding, and so I don't have to scroll code here, I captured this result in these slides. So let's just look at here, see what happened. This is actually very similar to the second scenario where the database was oversized, but still could not perform at the speed anticipated. So Aurora Postgres, in this case, doing an 80-20 read-write workload, without the ElastiCache, was able to execute about 2,700 transactions per second. However, in the second test, when we added the caching service to it, the performance was boosted up to close to 3,500 transactions per second. No change to the database and no change to the application. The only difference was that it was using the caching service. Now let's look at our second slide, where we're going to see the response time. So the first box here, the first graph, shows the performance of the database without the ElastiCache and the response time. The average response time, it's around 9 milliseconds. Pretty much throughout, the database performing quite well at around 9 milliseconds. However, when we added the caching service to it, the same database, the same workload, the response time dropped down to about 5 milliseconds, which is close to 50% reduction in time. Again, this is very similar to the claim that we did earlier with a 25 to 30% performance boost and a 50% drop in response time. Now, you might ask yourself that this solution only works for relational databases? No, this works for many other databases, actually works for just about any data. If any kind of data can be queried, it can be cached. ElastiCache does not have any limitations to the data type. In fact, it has many built-in data types that can be customizedly used for your application to help with specific solutions. But if none of them work, you could always use the defaults called the string data type, and any of these services actually can be used in conjunction with ElastiCache to boost performance. Thank you very much for your time. If you'd like to follow up and learn more about what we've done here, here are a couple of links. Just scan the QR codes. You can learn about more features and pricing of ElastiCache. If you'd like to write us an email, please do so to the following email address. Thank you very much.